Right, so welcome to another very important topic, that is term symbols. Okay, now before I begin, I just want to clear out a few things. I have my research report coming up, so I'll be really busy with that. So I would not be able to take up any further topics which you are requesting, but since many of you had requested MOSBA spectroscopy, and I had promised that I will make a video on that. So MOSBA spectroscopy and auricle diagrams, these two topics I will cover, but until about mid of October, I would not be able to take any more requests regarding the topics. But I'll be solving questions daily, and I'll try my best to put up named reactions that I have been putting up, right? And on the weekends, I will try that I can take up a few topics and, you know, explain them. So I'm really sorry for that, but I'm like really busy with my research work, okay? But anyway, I'll try my best and help you guys out. But I'll be solving questions and doing name reactions and everything, right? And on weekends, I'll try my best that I can cover as many topics as possible, okay? Anyway, so now coming on to term symbols. So term symbols, like, explaining it would be a little difficult for me. That's why I've taken so many examples. I'll be solving 7 questions from GATE and NET, and you will understand how simple it is. And from term symbols, definitely, for sure, a question is going to come. It has always come, and this time around also it will come, right? So in this particular video, I'll be talking about the basic term symbols, okay? There are term symbols that are derived from auricle diagram as well. That I'll talk about when I'll explain auricle diagram to you guys, right? So the basic, this term symbols is given by, it's something called as Russell-Saunders coupling, okay? And so there's this basic formula, which is 2s plus 1 L J. Okay, this is a very basic formula, 2s plus 1 L J, where our S is the spin quantum number, L is the orbital quantum number, or you can say orbital angular momentum. So this is spin momentum, this is orbital angular momentum, and J is the total angular momentum. Okay, and this J is given by L plus S, or J can also be given by L minus S, depending on whether the orbital is half filled or full filled, right? So for example, there is a d orbital and there are more than 5 electrons in d orbital, right? So it is more than half filled. So if it's more than half filled, then the formula L plus S formula is used for more than half filled. And if it's less than half filled, okay, half filled or more than half filled, we use formula L plus S. And if it's less than half filled, like it's D4, D3, D2, then we use L minus S formula. Okay, and like I'll insist again and again, things will get clearer once I start solving the questions. Okay, so this is the basic formula. Now this L is the orbital angular momentum. Okay, and I'll explain that later. Okay, now let's move to some 2s plus 1 lg. Okay. So for example, you have p1, right? That is, one of the electrons is there in the p orbital, right? Now if you draw the p orbital, here I represent plus 1, 0, minus 1, right? This is the magnetic quantum number, ML. So for this is for p orbital, it's plus 1, 0, minus 1. Okay. For example, I have taken p1. So the first electron is going to go in this particular orbital, right? With the magnetic quantum number plus 1. Now I'll come on to what is L. L is the orbital angular momentum, and L is represented by S, okay, or P or D or F. Capital, okay, S, P, D, F, and then this is basically the this is going on the order of orbitals. We have S orbital, P orbital, D orbital, F orbital, and then we have G, H, I, then we go alphabetically, okay. So S, P, D, F, these are based on the orbitals, and then we go alphabetically. G, H, I, J is not there because J is represented by the total or total angular momentum, so that's why we don't take J. So G, H, I, K, L, so it goes on alphabetically, okay. Now what is this S, P, D, F, and how do we come up with that? For example, if the magnetic quantum number, the overall sum of the magnetic quantum number, if it's 0, then L is represented by S. If it's 1, it is represented by P. If it is 2, it is represented by D. If it is 3, it's represented by F. If it's G, it's represented by 4, H by 5, and so on and so forth, right? So, for example, over here, the total magnetic quantum number is 1 because our first electron P1 is going in plus 1. So now the spin is what? Spin is half, right? Our spin is half, right? And our L is equal to 1 because the magnetic quantum number, the first electron is going in plus 1. So we have the formula 2S plus 1 L J, right? Where J equal to L minus S in this case, because over here this is less than half filled. So we S is half, so 2 into half plus 1, 2 into half plus 1 is 2. So 2 L is equal to 1, and for 1 what did I say? It's P. So 2P and J equal to L minus S. So L is 1, S is half, so 1 by 2. So this is the term symbol for this configuration, 2P half. This is the term symbol. Actually, it's called the level. Okay, I'll explain you the difference. This particular case over here, it's called level. This 2s plus 1, this whole term is called the multiplicity. This is called the multiplicity. Okay, and this term, this is the term symbol, you can say, like in CSIR net questions and gate questions. This thing is called either levels or term symbols, okay? But the correct definition is, it's called levels. Okay, this is called the levels. Now, what is the difference? So, if we are representing it in this fashion, it's called levels. And if we do not represent the value of J, that is, we just represent 2S plus 1 L. So, in this case, 2S plus 1 L will be 2P, right? This will be 2P. There is no J. We are not representing J in this case. So then this particular thing is called a term. This is called a term. So in the exam, you have to be careful. If they're asking you the term, you have to represent only the 2s multiplicity and the value of L. But if they're asking you level, then you have to represent the J value as well. Then you have to take into account whether it's half filled or full filled. If they're asking the term, then you do not care whether it's half filled or full filled, because because if they are asking the term, they are just asking the value of multiplicity and the value of L. They do not care whether it's half filled or full filled, right? Or more less than half filled. So this particular value, multiplicity and L, is called a term. And if you are giving the J value as well, then it's called a level. Okay? Okay. So now let's move on to if someone tells you to find the number of terms in say D2, let's take the example of D2. Okay, we have D2, I'm saying, correct? So there are 5 d orbitals, and the magnetic values are plus 2, plus 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2. Okay, these are the magnetic quantum number values. Now I said D2, so there are 2 electrons. Okay, now this is here. This is where it gets a little complicated. Okay. Now D2 means 2 electrons are there. Now in the exam, they'll ask you the possible terms. Okay, not the possible levels. The possible terms for D2 configuration. Now our first electron can go in this, and the second electron can go in this. All right. So 2s plus 1, s is equal to 1. So 2s plus 1, s is 1, so this will become 3. So the multiplicity for this particular case is 3 when both the electrons are unpaired. So we have 3, and what is the value of L? L value is plus 2 plus 1, so plus 3. So plus 3 L value means so plus 3 is PDF, so 3F, right? P was 1, D was 2, S was 0, and SPDF, F was 3. So we have 3F. So this is the term, right? So in the exam, they ask you, for example, what are the possible terms for D2 configuration? So this is our first term, right? So this is one of the terms. Now let's see other possibilities. You have to consider all the possibilities. Now let's see if both are paired. if both the electrons are paired. If both the electrons are paired, s is equal to 0. So 2s plus 1, s is 0. So that means multiplicity becomes 1. So the multiplicity is 1 and this is 4. Because there are 2 electrons, plus 2, plus 2, plus 4, right? And for 4 we have g. So this will become 1g. Now let's see other possibilities. Now other possibilities are both in plus 1. Okay, both in plus 1. So if both are in plus 1, then again the multiplicity will become 1 because spin is 0. And since plus 1, 2 electrons in plus 1 are the quantum number, so that means total sum is equal to plus 2. And for plus 2 we have d configuration. L is equal to d for plus 2. So we have 1d as well. Okay. And we can also have both electrons in 0. And if both electrons are in 0, then we have 1s. Because magnetic quantum number is also 0, that means L for 0 is s. And we have multiplicity as 1, so 1s. Now, what other possibilities are there? We can have 1 electron in plus 1. Sorry, the phone's memory got full and I completed the lecture. So, I'll start over again. So, yeah. So these are the four possible term symbols like I discussed. The fifth one is if we have 1 electron in this plus 1 and 1 electron in 0, right? So now the value of ML is, the magnetic quantum number is plus 1 plus 0, that is plus 1. And the value of L for plus 1 is P, right? And the multiplicity will be 2s plus 1 spin, so since it's parallel spin, so s is equal to 1, so the multiplicity 2s plus 1 is 3. So 3p. So these are the 5 possible term symbols for D2 configuration. Okay. And you must be wondering, why not, let's say, why not take plus 2 and 0, you know, like that, plus 2 and 0. So if you take plus 2 and 0, it will become D, L, the value of L is D, and our spin is, spin will become, since it's parallel spin, so it will become 3D. So why not 3D is a possible term symbol? Because when you are filling the orbitals, you cannot leave a gap, one gap, right? You have, the filling of the orbitals has to be continuous. So that means if you are filling one in plus one, then the other one should be in zero. You cannot leave a gap. Okay, so just remember that whenever you are filling the orbitals, just remember that you do not leave a gap in between. The filling should be continuous. Okay, so only those term symbols are possible where the filling is continuous. Okay, so now let's discuss a bit about before moving to my number of microstates for a possible term. I would also like to discuss one important thing, that if, for example, we have P1, okay, or we have D1 configuration, right? So you might think that the first electron can go here plus 1, right? And we can have a configure, and we can have s is equal to half, so 2p is the possible term symbol, right? And we can also have the electron going in, say, 0. We can also have the electron going in 0. You might wonder that why not the electron goes in 0, right? And then we can have a possible term symbol as 2s. Why not this? Okay, but this 2s is not a valid term symbol for P1 configuration. And the reason for that is, whenever you are putting the first electron, if there is only one electron, then you will always put it in the highest magnetic quantum number. Okay, and the reason for that is, according to Hund's rule, okay, the value of that particular term is the most probable term where the value of L is maximum. So if you put it in 0, the value of L becomes 0. But if you put it in plus 1, the value of L becomes P. The value of L is 1, that is P configuration, right? So then the term will become 2P. That's why similarly for D1 also, we have plus 2, plus 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2. So the possible term symbol for D1 also is 2D. Because the electron goes in plus 2, and plus 2 means L is equal to plus 2 means D, symbol D, and multiplicity 2s plus 1, so s is equal to half, so 2 into half plus 1, that is 2. But we cannot take it for plus 1, because again, according to the Hund's rule, that term symbol would not be the probable term symbol, because the most probable term symbol is where the value of L is maximum, right? And the value of L will be maximum only in case of plus 2. Okay. Now let's discuss a bit about number of microstates. Okay. So the number of microstates is nothing but, for example, if we take the term 2p, if you are given the term 2p and they ask you the number of microstates for the term 2p. So number of microstates is given by 2s plus 1 into 2l plus 1, where our 2s plus 1 is the multiplicity and it's nothing but the value given over here, that is 2. This 2 is also the multiplicity. So we can say 2s plus 1. So this is equal to 2 into 2l plus 1. Now l in this case is equal to 1 because it's the p term. So 2 into 1 plus 1, right? So that becomes equal to 2 into 2, 6. So the number of microstates is 6. Okay. Now if similarly, this is the term symbol for, like I told you, P1 configuration. Now let's take, if for example you are given P1 configuration, you are not given the term, you are given P1 configuration, that is NP1. Let's say you are given NP1 and you are told to find the number of microstates. Now if you are given the term, then this is the formula 2s plus 1 into 2l plus 1. But if you are given the electronic configuration, that is in this case NP1, so then it will be the formula is given by n factorial upon r factorial into n minus r factorial, where n is the number of electrons, the maximum number of electrons that can be occupied by the orbital. So over here it's a p orbital. Now p orbital can accommodate a maximum of 6 electrons. So 6 factorial upon r is the number of electrons that we have to accommodate. Now it's given p1, so only one electron we have to accommodate. So 1 factorial upon n minus r. Now n minus r is 5 factorial, right? 6 minus 1, 5. So if you calculate this, this comes out to be 6. So if you are given the electronic configuration, then the formula is n factorial upon r factorial into n minus r, where n is the number of electrons, maximum number of electrons that the orbital can accommodate. So if it was d orbital, then the formula would become 10, because the orbital can accommodate 10 electrons. So 10, it would have become 10 factorial. And r is the number of electrons that we have to occupy. So if it's given d5, so then r will become 5. Okay, so like that you can calculate the number of microstates. And for the if the term is given, then the formula is 2s plus 1 into 2l plus 1. Okay, now let's do some questions and things will get clearer. So one, I told you two rules. Okay, so there are, one rule is that the that particular term symbol is the most probable, where, or the least energy. Most probable means it is of least energy, that where the value of L is maximum. Okay, and the second is that the multiplicity should also be maximum, that is the value of 2s plus 1 should be maximum. The more the multiplicity means the more the parallel spin electrons. So the more the multiplicity, the stable the symbol, and it is more likely to occur. That is, it is the ground term symbol. Okay, so because if there are more number of unpaired electrons, okay, with parallel spins, then what happens is exchange energy. You might have heard of exchange energy. So there is extra stability comes because of that exchange energy, and that's why when there are more parallel spins, or you can say there is more multiplicity, then that term symbol is more probable of lower energy, and it's known as the ground state symbol. Okay. Now let's do questions. Okay. And let me check whether it's filming or not. Just a second. Right. So now let's do some questions. So we have 1G microstates. This came in GATE 2014. So they had given the term 1G and they had asked the number of microstates. Now if you calculate the 1G, so you take the formula 2S plus 1 into 2L plus 1. Okay, so S over here is, if you calculate, the multiplicity is given 1. So 1 into 2L plus 1. Now L if it's g, I told you l will be equal to s. For s it's 0, for p it's 1, for d it's 2, for f 3, sp df, and for g 4. So 2 into 4 plus 1. So 2 into 4 plus 1. So that means the answer is 9. So the number of possible microstates is 9. And this came for 2 marks in GATE 2014. It took you 5 seconds, max 5 seconds. Not more than that. Okay, then the next question is, this is the electronic configuration given to us. 1s2, 2s2, 2s1, 3s1. Okay, this is the configuration given to us. 1s2, 2s1, 3s1. And they are asking the lowest energy state. Okay, the lowest energy state or the ground state, you can say. They are asking the particularly asking the lowest energy state. Now we have 2s1 and 3s1. Okay, so one electron in s orbital. Both electrons are actually in s orbital. It's just one is in 2s and one is in 3s. So it does not make much difference. But since they are in different orbitals, so let's say we have one orbital, this is 2s, and then we have 3s. So the magnetic number for s orbital is 0, okay? And so we have one electron filled over here and one electron filled over here. Now it's asking the lowest energy state. Now I told you the lowest energy state will be the one according to Hund's rule where the multiplicity is maximum. That is, we have to take parallel spins, okay? So now you have taken parallel spins, right? And the so if you have taken the parallel spins, so formula is 2s plus 1. S becomes 1, so this value becomes 3, right? And our L value will be 0, because here also the value is 0, here also the value is 0. The magnetic number value is 0. So 3 into L is 0, so 3s, right? And so 3s. So if you look, and they're asking, they have given the term symbols or their levels, because they have given 1 as 0, 1d2, 3s1, 3p1. They are not asking the term, they are asking the term symbol or the levels. So now you have to calculate the level also. Now both of them, if we calculate the level, it's the formula is L plus S. Right? The formula is L plus S. Okay? And for S orbital, because I told you, if for S orbital, it will remain L plus S. It can be L plus S or L minus S, it does not matter because L is 0, right? So S is 1 because spin is 1, so 3s1. So the correct option is option number 3, right? And this came in GATE 2008, and same question, I'll tell you, it was repeated in June 2015. And that's why I'm stressing again and again that you have to solve both GATE and NET questions, because they are repeated, okay? The same question came in GATE 2008, which was repeated recently in June 2015. Okay. Now, next question is, it's given vanadium plus 3, and they're asking the ground state term symbol. They're asking the ground state term, okay? Now, they're not asking the level or the term symbol, they're asking the term. So, we do not have to calculate the value of J. Okay, so vanadium plus 3, so scandium, titanium, vanadium. And in plus 3, scandium, titanium, D2 configuration. Okay, vanadium in plus 3 is D2. Okay, now in D2 configuration, it's asking the ground state term symbol. So again, ground state term means the multiplicity should be maximum. So plus 2, plus 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2. Multiplicity should be maximum, that is, both the spins should be parallel. Okay. But what should be the value of L? Now I told you again, the multiplicity is 1, the ground state symbol is 1. First of all, the multiplicity should be maximum, and the second condition is the value of L should be maximum. So only in this case will the value of L be maximum. Because if we take them to be, the value of L can be maximum if we take both in the same orbital, in the plus 2. So now the value of L will become 4. That is, it will become G, right? But we have to consider both the multiplicity as well as the value of L. So here the multiplicity will become 1, which is less. Whereas if we take 1 in plus 2 and 1 in plus 1, then the multiplicity remains 3, because 2 into 1 plus 1, 2s plus 1, right? So the multiplicity becomes 3, and our value of L is L for magnetic quantum number 3 is S for 0, L for 1, P for 2, P for 1, S, P, D, D for 2 and F. So 3F. So the correct option is option number 1, 3F. This came in GATE 2007. Okay. So the next question is possible values of 3D. This came in NET, June 2011. Possible values, possible J values of 3D. So it's asking the possible J values for the term 3D. The term is given 3D. Okay. Now you should first of all know the difference. If it's given 3 is given at the prefix and then 3D is given like this. So this is the term. Okay. But if it's given D3, then it's the electronic configuration. Remember this. Okay. If it's given 3 is given in the prefix, then it's the term. Or they'll mention the for the term 3D. Okay. And if they have not mentioned the term and they have given it like D3, then it's the electronic configuration. So you should know the difference. Okay, so 3D. Now possible J values for 3D. So first of all, it's asking the J values for 3D. That means L is already given to us and S is also already given to us. Because the term is given to us, it's asking specifically for 3D. And if it's D, so the value of L becomes... The value of L becomes SPD. L becomes 2. And the value of S is 2S plus 1 is equal to 3. Because this is the multiplicity. So the value of S is S equal to 1. So we are given L is 2 and S is 1. So the possible J values is from L plus S to L minus S. These are the possible J values. Our L value is 2 plus 1, that is 3, and L minus S is 2 minus 1, 3 to 1. Okay, so we have integer values as 3, 2 and 1. So these are the possible J values, and if you see the options, the possible J values 3, there are 3 possible J values, 3, 2, 1. So the correct answer is 3. Okay. Now the next question is based on the similar concept. The levels of 3D they are asking. That is the number of terms for 3D. So the levels of 3D will be, and it's asking for the particular term 3D. So like you calculated for 3D, what were the J values? The J values were 3, 2 and 1. These are the 3 J values that we got. So the possible levels for 3D will be 3D, 3, 3D, 2 and 3D. 1. These are the possible levels for 3D term. Okay. It's calculated with a similar way. You just calculate the J value. You are given the S value, you are given the D value. So you calculate the possible J values. Okay. Okay. So the next question is, it's given. I'll take this one, the 6th question, the last, because it's a little tough, okay? And this question came in December 2014, levels of 3D, okay? Now I'll take an example of June 2015 paper, we are given NS1 and NP1. And we are asking, they are asking the ground state term for NS1, NP1. NS1, NP1. So we'll draw the structure. So one electron, and we have P, one electron. Now I told you multiplicity should be maximum, that is both the spins should be parallel. So our multiplicity becomes 3. Okay, and it is asking the term. It's asking the level. It's not asking the term because it's given 3P1, 1P1, 3P2, 3P0. Okay, so 3 is the multiplicity. Now let's calculate the L value. The L value should also be maximum. So 0 for S and plus 1 for P. Okay, so L value becomes 3P. So L is 1, so the value becomes P. And the formula is L minus S, right? L minus S because it's less than half filled. See, S orbital, you have to see both the orbitals. Now, S orbital is half filled. It does not matter for S orbital, okay? You do not have to calculate half filled or full filled for S orbital. You only see the P orbital. Now, P orbital is less than half filled, okay? So, you will take the formula L minus S. So, L is given 1 and S is also 1. So, the formula, so the value of J is 0. So 3P0. So this is the ground state term symbol. Okay. Now don't get confused. See, when they are asking you the possible J values, means you have to write all possible J values from L plus S to L minus S. Okay. But if they are asking you the ground state term, then you have to write only one term symbol or one level or one sorry one term or one level only, because you cannot get more than one levels if you have to write only one ground state symbol. So do not get confused. When they are asking you possible, you have to write all possible values. But when they are asking you ground state, then there is only one ground state term symbol that can be possible. Okay, now let's move on to the last question. That is Sumerian 3 plus European 3 plus. Okay, and Sumerian 3 plus and European 3 plus. Now let's draw the, if you haven't seen my lanthanides video, I'll post the link over here. Just watch it, because that is very important. Because the configurations in lanthanides is a little tough. It's a little different, not tough, it's a little different. Okay, so. There should be 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Missing out on 1. DY. So they are asking for Sumerian 3 plus and European 3 plus. They have given us Sumerian 3 plus and European 3 plus. And they're asking the ground state term for Sumerian 3 plus and Europium 3 plus. Okay, so lanthanum, so they all have 6s. These all have 6s, 6s 2 electrons. Okay, and we have 4f and 5d. So for 5d, only lanthanum has 5d and cerium has 5d, and they have 4f0. Okay, I'll again repeat how you fill them. Okay. I actually would not repeat, you just look at my video, okay? I'll just do the calculation. So we have, you just look up the configurations, okay? I'm not going to do it. Right. So for samarium, it's 4F, for samarium, the configuration is 4F6, 6S2. Right, 4F6, 6S2. Now, if it's given samarium 3 plus, that means the number of the electronic configuration becomes 4F5. So we have 4F5 electronic configuration for samarium. You solve for europium yourself. I'll just do the samarium 3 plus. So again, I'll draw the F. Now you have to find the ground state term symbol. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So plus 3, plus 2, plus 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and 5 electrons. Maximum, first of all, multiplicity should be maximum. That means the 5 should be of parallel spin. So plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. And also the L value should be maximum. So the L value is maximum in this case only. So we have plus 3, plus 2, plus 5, plus 1, plus 6. 6 minus 1, 5. So L value is 5. Now for 5, L is H. So we have H. Multiplicity is 2s plus 1. So 2 into 5 by 2 plus 1. So the value is 6H. Okay. And they are also asking the level. They are asking the level, ground state level. Now to calculate the level, now it's more, less than half filled. So the formula is L minus S. L is 6, right? The L value is 5. Sorry. So 5 minus spin value is 5 by 2. So this becomes 5 by 2. So the ground state level or ground state term symbol is 6H5/2. So these are some of the questions, and this particular question came in December 2013. I think this is one of the toughest questions for term symbols, because you also need to know the accurate configuration of lanthanides. And you can try for European yourself, okay? And if you have any doubt, you can post a comment below, okay? So term symbols is quite an important topic, and it definitely questions will come in all the formats, be it GATE, NET or CHA. Okay.